This is to do with all trucks. You will see it as we go through the Western Abatoma. Turn all these, there are no more trucks in that area. So we tactically send the best cities. If we are going to relieve, I'm sure we have a lead. Let's give the contract. That was how we asked for the 2 weeks. So that the contractor has started cutting this road and putting concrete. About 5 sections of this road he has put concrete. After that, I think there is one close to the truck. This one, are you sure it's here or there? All the way to my children. Then we have gone as far as more than halfway. We have secured the right of way for it so it can walk. After this, then he will tap it and put the final concrete. The same thing on the other lane. There are 2 potholes down there, sir. If you carry export, the 3-lane road became 1 lane in an attempt everybody to stop. Yeah, it says by Monday we have that. So once we have that, we have the trailer park, we are going to throw open by 2. So all the trucks come, instead of them staying on the road now, we will force as much as we can force into the trailer park. Once my 2 is free, we will create a lane. They've agreed to put barricade so that commercial vehicles can move from my 2 to port, and that will be the ultimate, so that people can say they can move.
The completion of the trailer parks, what's going on in Lilypond, and the palliatives along these roads, the completion of some of the infrastructure around the ports. So there are several different issues, and we, you know, what I've seen so far, it's been largely satisfactory. I'm quite pleased with the pace of work. There are one or two things that we think would require a bit more, maybe a bit more speed. Improve the infrastructure around the ports area. Improve the call-up system so that tankers can go back and forth, so that there is no pressure on those who are trying to drop their containers and all of that. Just to ensure that we're able to move around quickly. You must never forget that this port really moves about 34 million metric tons of traffic, of cargo, but is now doing well over 80. So there are several things that we're doing, you know, in order to make it easier to use this port, and also in order to for the entire trade experience, for the entire import and export experience as well. So we're dredging the Warri ports, you know, we're using barges now and all of that. And also, as you know, the rail link from the ports, which is part of the Lagos Kano rail link, the rail link from Apapa all the way to Ekwutemeta and all the way out, will be an important part of the transportation, the transportation system out of the ports. So lots of cargo will be able to move by rail. So we're looking at an intermodal solution. There's water, there's rail, there's land, and I'm sure we'll resolve it.
So timelines?
Oh, there are several timelines for the best, for the most efficient use of the port.